One of Notion's biggest updates in the past few years inspired us to create a new type of Notion CRM. Notion's newly released home feature is a game changer for businesses that use Notion. It provides a central place where all of your work can come together. It gives you the ability to view all of your tasks you own in the My Tasks section. The ability to view all of your tasks you own in the My Tasks section is particularly important because it solves one of Notion's most common business use cases, client portals. As you can see here in the My Tasks section, I have tasks from two different sources, one for a fake client named Eco Green, and then one for another called Novotech. With Notion's new home feature, businesses are finally able to bring together all the tasks from separate client portals that you're using to track billable hours, client projects, and much more. Before the new home feature, it was a very manual process to put together all of the tasks inside of each one of your client portals in one place. With this update, Notion has firmly placed itself as the best client portal solution that doesn't break the bank. With as little as $8 a month, you have the ability to create unlimited client portals. This is because when you share portals with clients, all you have to do is simply hit the share button and enter their email here, and they are granted guest access, which is completely free. The only problem is that creating client portals that seamlessly integrate with the rest of your Notion workspace is difficult and a long process that most business owners don't have the time for. Don't worry, because we have a Notion CRM that integrates client portals with companies, deals, contacts, projects and tasks, and OKRs to make sure you're hitting your goals. Let me show you how it works. Up here, we have a simple navigation bar that allows you to click into your databases and easily be able to create new records. This navigation bar exists on most pages for you to be able to get around in the CRM efficiently. On the left-hand side, we have the list of all of the client portals that are currently active. Here are some active objectives that you're currently pursuing. You're able to see what are the internal tasks for the week and what is the timeline for the projects that you're working on. Now let's go through the process of creating a company that we're going to go through deal stages with and ultimately have one as a customer. And we're going to start projects together and tracking all of the work that we're doing in their very own client portal. So I'm going to go ahead and click into the company's database. And when you do so, you can see that we have the navigation bar here. But then we have a list of our companies, who are our customers, who are our prospects, a list of our customers sorted by lifetime value, meaning how much have they brought to our business over time, and then by open pipeline so you can see the biggest deals that you're currently trying to close. You also can fill out fields like what is their industry, who are the individuals that work at that company, the type, whether they're a prospect, customer, partner, former customer, or competitor, the deals associated with them. Maybe you have some internal projects like you're doing a onboarding for getting them started, LinkedIn, website, their associated client portal, and what is their billing address. And of course, with Notion, you can create any properties that are relevant for your own specific business. Let's come over here to the companies tab, and I'm going to create a new fake company. I'm going to enter the company name here. Let's go ahead and assign it an industry. For now, it's going to be a prospect. Let's enter our website, a billing address. And then once we've entered in some of that basic information, let's go ahead and create a contact that works at this business. So to do that, I'm going to select new contact. And when we create it, it is automatically related to that company we created. And then let's give this contact a name. Once you've entered some contact information, we're going to come back to the company. And now when we come to the contacts, you can see that this demo contact is related, as well as any additional contacts that you create for this company will show up here. Now let's add a new deal. And just so you know, you can either use this button or you can just add the deal by selecting in this table here. For this example, let's go ahead and add directly from the table. So I'm going to hit new, and then I'm going to enter the company name. And then my recommendation is to add exactly which service they're buying from you so you can easily see in views. So for this company, I'm going to say that they're buying my Notion consulting services. After you've entered the name, let's go ahead and enter a amount. Then you're going to enter what stage it is in. You can add your own stages, but I've entered some basic ones for you to get started. It's good to follow a sequential order so you can tell exactly where deals are in the process compared to others. So in this example, prospecting would be the very start of us working together. They've shown a little bit of interest, but it's really unknown at this point whether or not they're going to move forward with us. And then a stage like negotiation would be where you've already sent them their contract, and you should be hearing any day from now whether or not they're going to go ahead and become a customer. But for this example, we're going to say that they went ahead and decided that they wanted to utilize our services. So we're just going to move them directly into closed one. And then for type, This is our first time ever working with this business, so we're going to select new. And then if it was in one of those earlier stages, you can enter in what the probability is going to be in terms of them closing with you. Because they already close, it's obviously high, so I'm going to enter that in there. And then you can enter the day that they decided to become a customer in this close date field. And then the last step to make sure that you've entered in everything that you need to show that they're a customer in the system is come up here to type and change it from prospect to customer so that they show up in views as a customer. Now it's time to start getting to work with this client and send over their client portal so that they can be impressed by our level of professionalism. So I'm going to come over here to the left-hand side and select new client portal. Once this client portal loads, let's go ahead and enter the client portal name. So we're going to just name it demo company portal. Then let's enter in a example project. So we're going to select new here. Then we're going to name this project example project. Then we're going to start adding some tasks that are associated with this project. So I'm just going to enter a couple here. So I'm going to say example one and example two. And you can see that they show up here in this board view and you can drag and drop them to change their statuses. And now that we're clicked into this specific project, we probably want to go back into the client portal itself. So go back into the agency CRM home and you can see that the demo company portal has been added with our other portals here. We're just going to simply open it as a page. And then we can see example one, example two tasks being pulled up here. And also, if we had any documents that we wanted to associate with projects, we can add them here. To show your clients how much time you're spending on particular tasks and build that transparency and trust, you're going to click into one of your tasks and you're going to select this automation, new time entry. It's going to create a time entry in our time tracker database. And when we do it, it automatically timestamps the start time and sets the status as running. Now, when we go ahead and select end time entry, you can see that it's a minute difference and we can see the sum of how much we spent. Let's add another time entry here and then end it. And then let's add some unique times here. So let's say that this one ended up taking an hour and then this one ended up taking a couple hours. And then you can see overall, now that we move some of these end times, you can see that we spent 181 minutes and a total of 3 hours that you can bill to your client for this particular task. And if you wanted to see all the time that you've spent across all of your tasks, you simply come into the time tracker and here you can sum all of the tasks you have and you're able to filter on whether it's this month or last month, how much time you spent working for them. As I mentioned at the start of this video, to share this portal with your clients, you simply just need to enter their emails in here and then they need to sign up for Notion accounts, which will be free. And then they'll be granted guest access to this page alone. And with the way that I set up the CRM, they only get access to this specific portal and not any of your other customer data. To make sure that this task database is shown with all of your other client portals in Notion's home feature, what we're going to do is we're going to rename this database here, this task database, to demo company tasks. And that will make it really easy for us to find in the home feature and filter on the source. So go ahead and open up your navigation and come to home. And to add in this new client portal, we're going to select filter. And then we're going to filter based on the source. And the reason why it's important to add that company name inside that database that we just did is that you might have many other task databases. And a lot of them are probably just going to be named tasks, just like I have here. So we're going to scroll down and find the specific task database for that demo company. So we're going to select demo company here. And then you can see it pull in. Now let's go ahead and assign some due dates as well. And if you so choose, you can go ahead and add additional properties that may be important to you. So let's say, for example, we just want to see the created by here in this table. You can add that. And then the database is filtered based on statuses that are in progress or not started. So if we go ahead and we move, for example, this example two to done, is automatically removed from our My Tasks. If you'd like a bigger view to look at My Tasks, you can open as a full page and you're able to see all this data here. In this CRM, you also have projects and tasks that are for internal. And these databases are separated so that you and your team can only see them and your clients cannot. So examples of where this might be useful is internal marketing objectives, onboarding customers, and so on. If you'd like these internal tasks to show up inside of the home feature, simply follow the steps that we just did for the client portal. Now let's touch on OKRs and how they can benefit your business. So first off, we have this objectives database, which is going to be for setting ambitious long-term goals that have measurable results. So examples that I've entered in here are Q1 2024 revenue, we want to hit 20,000. And then for Q1 2024, we want to gain a social media following of 5,000. You can enter the timeframes. What is their status? Whether they're on track, at risk, failed, or you ultimately passed. And then you're able to tie key results that funnel into these objectives. So let's add an objective here and then some key results. So let's say that also in Q1, we want to write 10 blog posts. So I'm going to select new here, and then I'm going to enter in Q1, 10 blog posts. Let's enter the type of marketing, and you can enter other types here that are relevant for your business. Then we're going to enter in the target of 10. Let's set the time frame for Q1. So we're going to go from January 1st until March 31st. We're just getting started, so we're going to select on track. And then let's associate some key results. So I'm going to click into this box, and we're going to say January blog posts. We're then going to create it. And then let's again select that time frame from Jan 1st to March 31st. And then let's say for January, we wanted to hit 4. And we actually ended up hitting 4. You can see up here, the progress is automatically adjusted. So since we're at 4 out of 10, we're 40% towards our 10 blog post goal. You then enter in how many blog posts you want to get for February and March, and what is the current value, as well as what is that target value. So to reach our 10 blog post goal, we'd want something like 3 blog posts in February and March. And when you've ultimately passed that goal, simply select it as passed so that you know that you've achieved it and you can move on to achieving the next thing for your business. Once you've added that new objective and set the status as either on track or at risk, it will show up in the active objectives page on the homepage of the CRM. And every time you log in for the day, it'll help motivate you towards reaching your goals. That's it for this demonstration. I made sure that the CRM is as simple as possible, that you can spend as much time focusing on delivering value for your clients, but also giving you the ability to track how much revenue your business is winning, all the contact information, and other relevant CRM data. If you're actively working with clients or plan to, I highly recommend you give this Notion CRM a try. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.